One of my jobs that I really love to remember is being in England and completely penniless, speaking very little language, and getting job to the postwoman. So I get into this very horribly ugly uniform. It's too tight for me, short sleeves, you know, little skirt and ugly shoes. And then I have to, you know, deliver the post. As I don't know the city, I don't know English. It took me till 3 in the morning. I was still delivering post in different streets of London. And after about 3 months working really hard, I decided I should have complete different attitude, change everything. Then I decided, in those days there was no, you know, internet, it was all, and there was typewriter machines, there was no any kind of computers. So I decided every letter was written with a typewriter, must be some official news or some emails with, some checks with, you know, the bad news. So I throw them away. And only the letters written by hand must be love letters, something intimate, something emotional, I deliver. So I was, you know, a few hours ready with my job, very happy. After 2 weeks, they asked me to, you know, to give back the uniform. It was my old professor of the painting, and I was a student. And he said to me something I will never forget. He said to me, if you're an artist, and you start making drawings with your right hand, and you come better and better and better. So you become like a virtuoso. You can make, even with closed eyes, a really great, fast drawing. Immediately change to left hand, because you will repeat yourself. This was lesson number one. And the second lesson, he said to me, as an artist, if you're very lucky and you're very good, you can have one good idea. But if you're a genius, you maybe have two good ideas, but this is all. And be very careful with them. In art, it was so hard to create situation when performance become mainstream art. And you know, in the beginning, the people really ridicule this type of work. They never took it serious. They laugh about. They think that that was nonsense. That was ridiculous. Somehow, even it was many low points in this in my career. I never see them as low points, because somehow deep inside of me, I was so sure I was right, no matter what, and I didn't care about bad critics. And my all low points come from my personal life. And it's really to do with the family, with the men I love, and somehow injustice. I always felt that, you know, they never could understood the amount of sacrifice I'm doing to make this work. And somehow they always think, I always felt guilty that I'm doing so much, that always somebody is waiting for me, and I'm always not doing enough in my private life. Till the point that I decided, you know, I have to give up private life and really embrace loneliness. And now I'm so balanced and happy, because nobody's waiting there, and I can do absolutely what my art needs to be done. I teach more than 25 years, and I was so proud when my students have success and they can really make the career and they can put into practice all what I learned them without copying my work, but finding their own expression, their own selves. This is something that I think that I have the biggest joy in my life, that I see this happen. I'm very rarely reading like a roman or history. When I was young, I did that, but I really love the. And right now I'm just reading the Mercy Eliade, the book of shamanism, which to me is very interesting. Is the facts of the indigenous cultures and how they can incorporate the spirits and use the energy. It's something that I'm learning, you know, to do myself. Long time a friend of mine just made the one work which I like so much. Is he takes just a simple piece of white paper and put in a Xerox machine, and then they became out of, he pressed the button and came a copy, and copy was another white piece of paper, and then he put this white, two white pieces of papers on the wall, and you call, one is original, one is the copy. I like that. I am actually right now trying to raise $15 million, which is an enormous amount of money for a single artist. It's just through the websites, through the Kickstarters, through the people who really follow my work and want themselves that this institute happen, because they can experience through the institute, you know, in different way, time, space, and different ideas about art. So that's something that I am so interesting to talk about. And I think that I'm now making the website, so I think that very soon everybody can actually have access to these ideas. If I will not make art, I will be astronaut. Astronaut is something that really fascinates me. If you will tell me now, go to the spaceship and go to the different, the solar system, and you will never come back, I will do immediately. I really wanted to know, as a child, my main question was, not what is the cosmos, but what is behind the cosmos? That's something I always want to know. And as a child, I was always thinking that we are all sitting in the hill of the big cosmic fat lady, and she's kicking us around, and we have no any kind of control of it.